I want to talk a little bit more about the VR template and how to take existing projects and add them into your VR template so that you can navigate them in VR. Okay, because I know that's something that a lot of us will want to do. And in fact, the project we've been working on for this class can be brought into VR if you want to try that out. So I'm in another project here. Let's go through the whole process so that we know what we're doing. I've done a little more testing on it to figure out how to figure out what the best way is to do it for me that works quite easily. So let's just do a new project and do a virtual reality template. And again, to minimize how much stuff we have in there, we'll turn down or turn off all of this stuff. We'll say VR import. Create the project. Okay, we can save this one I'm in. Great. Give that a second to load up. Okay, now we've got a blank VR template created and we called it VR import, right? Now let's go back to open project and go to the project we've been working on. I think it's this one for me. And the reason I created that blank VR project is so that I have somewhere to migrate this stuff to. I'm going to show you how to migrate this. And then we can just take that and add it into our VR template. So what we're going to do is migrate this entire map here and everything that is attached to it into that other scene. So we need to find this map in our content browser. Okay, so by typing in first person example map, you can see the name of the level here. Type it in. You can find it in content. If we select that and hit asset actions, migrate. This gives us a hierarchy of everything that's attached to this level. So all the objects in here are going to come, but everything that is attached to them, including blueprints or anything like that, will also come. Okay, so you can see there's a blueprint in here, a trigger box that was from a later section of this course, but it's going to come with us because it's doing something in the scene. So hit OK. Now it's going to ask you where to migrate that to, and that's why I created that other portion. VR test, no. So now I just need to find that other VR test or that VR import project. Once you find VR import, you can go to the content folder, and that's where you want to tell this first person map to be imported to. Okay, there's some overriding because I had already imported some VR into there. That's fine. Yeah, we'll just overwrite this. Usually you won't have that problem, probably. Content migration completed successfully. Okay, good. Now we can go to our other project again, and it will have this level in there, which is awesome. VR import. Now we'll have to do a few more adjustments to make the VR actually work in there, and we'll be set and ready to go. Now this migrate tool can be used for anything, obviously, and it's a good way to share assets between projects. So let's open level. First person example, and here we are in a VR template with our level. Okay, and the reason we do this is because the VR template, you saw when we set it up with different kinds of settings. So you can either in your existing project go in and try to change all those settings to something that looks more like the VR template, or you can just do what I just did and bring it into here. I think this is easier, because it's hard to find all the stuff that affects the VR template by just looking through all your settings. So I think it's easier to just bring it into a VR template where everything's right and then just get all your geometry and lights and all that stuff and blueprints into here. Okay, now we do need to set up the navigation mesh, make sure that's right. Okay, because that's not gonna be here with the level, obviously. So like I said, we need some geometry here. And then we need a nav mesh bounce. Now I've showed you how to make that with the brush. Let's make it with the actual volume that's here. Nav mesh bounce volume. And like I said, the brush can be converted into this quite easily. But you can also bring it directly in. So let's bring our nav mesh bounce over. And there's just a few things we need to do to get this all working. Okay, you can see our nav mesh bounce is already going. Go to perspective view and look in there. Okay, our floor is all covered with green, which means we can navigate around in here with VR, which is great. Now, these cameras would go away. You don't want that anymore. That's just for that mirror reflection. Okay. There was one other camera in here. There. These ones were for those ones are for our real-time animations that we rendered. So those are fine, whatever. The thing we need to search for now, because we're in the template for VR, there should be a VR pawn in here. Actually, it's called motion control pawn. There it is right there, motion controller pawn, and that's going to be our new pawn, our new main character. Okay, and it gets placed at 0, 0. Well, wherever your floor is where it gets placed, because then when you put on the headset, it will lift up to your eye height, and you'll be walking around at your actual size and height. So that's where you want that. Now, the last thing you have to do to make this work is to go here with the pawn selected, and it needs to auto-possess player 0. Okay, that means this is the starting player. This is the default player. That's how it's set up in the game settings. And that means that this pawn is now going to be controlling your scene. And that should be everything you need to get in here. All the other scripts, the BP motion controller, the HMD location pawn, that depends on if you're using the Rift or the HTC Vive, whatever. But these are the blueprints that will run the navigation, the warping capabilities, and the grabbing capabilities of your VR headset. So now that this is your first player, you should be able to navigate around in here. You should be able to warp to anywhere where it's green. And if you put some grabbable objects in here, you should be able to grab them. Now, in the next sections after this, I'm going to be talking about blueprints. I've already made those videos, so I'm coming back to this one. But I'm going to talk a lot about events that trigger things, like this trigger box here. When you overlap this, it turns on lights. One thing that you'll want to do with VR, and I talked about this in the last video, how you can make objects grabbable. So there's the one meter cube. This one, and one of them is one you can pick up. What's that thing called? Pickup. There, BP pickup cube. Okay, so bring this in. Actually, let's do what I showed you before and make a copy of it, duplicate it. Button. Let's call it a button. Okay, so that can be a... Let's open this. Change the static mesh. Okay, the scripting is already in here, and everything's set up already to be a grabbable object, which is great. We can change the static mesh to whatever we want. One cool thing is if you change this to a chair and then placed it properly, then that chair in your scene, you could pick it up and throw it around, and physics would be applied to it. It'd be cool. It's fun to throw chairs in here, trust me. Okay, but let's make it a little cylinder. Compile and save. Okay, then we can just drag it into our scene. And now this becomes a VR button, a floating VR button. Let's say on this wall right here, whatever we want to do with it. Okay, now there's a big old button on that wall. Kind of funny looking. But that's okay. This is one way that we can use interaction in VR, and I kind of like this. So now if we go over here and grab this cylinder on the wall, we can make something happen. Okay, so let me show you. We'll talk more about blueprints later, but here's the events. So instead of picking that up, what this script is doing is when that's picked up, in other words, when you walk over to it and grab it with your trigger button on your HTC Vive, then all this is going to happen. And basically what this is it's going to attach to your hand, and physics is going to be applied to it. So you're going to pick it up. It's going to be sitting in your hand. But if we deleted all that, we could now say, okay, when we pick that up, instead of it attaching to my hand, let's do something else, like print string, hey, don't grab me. Okay. So in VR, if you went up to that and grabbed it, you would see that this would now run, and on your screen it would say, hey, don't grab me. Okay? That's obviously not a very useful script, but this is how you work interaction into VR. You can use the event pickup event, and make it do whatever you want. So, for example, you could turn on lights, change materials by pushing that button. Okay, so we'll get more into that as we go into blueprints, but just know that this is a good way. I'll show you overlap events and other things like that, but this is a good event to use to trigger something. Okay, you can also use trigger boxes and that kind of stuff. But in VR, I found this is a good way to trigger some sort of event by just grabbing an object. Okay, so that can be your button. And in the next sections, I'll show you how to use blueprints to do things to use trigger events, to turn on and off lights, to do other things. And if you're working in VR, just remember that you can use the event pickup event to trigger some of those exact same things. So keep that in mind as we move forward. But that's how you use the VR template. It's pretty much that easy. You just have to worry about that navigation mesh and everything should be good. And make sure that your motion pawn is in there and is possessing player zero, and you should be good to go.